I mean, research has shown that as little as 10 minutes of leisurely exercise a week can reduce your risk of death by 18%. 10 minutes a week. And let me reiterate something else. This is 10 minutes of leisurely activity. This isn't 10 minutes of ab crunches. You don't even have to run on a treadmill for 10 minutes. It's 10 minutes of pretty chill movement. Now, the phrase reducing the risk of death is kind of a weird, confusing phrase. It almost makes it sound like you'll suddenly be less likely to be hit by a car or fall down the stairs or something. Well, not exactly. In this case, it's specifically referring to deaths linked with cardiovascular disease and cancer, which are the top two leading causes of death in the United States. So, this is a big deal. What activities can you do today to start gaining these benefits? Here's what science recommends. Number one, walking. Yeah, walking. Even this, the simplest of human movement, is included in the list of leisurely activities that adults can do to prevent death. Walking is a weight-bearing exercise, which pretty much just means that you're carrying your own body weight as you do it. It's a very general way to increase cardiovascular and pulmonary fitness, which can lead to reduced risk of heart disease and stroke, manage your high blood pressure, increase endurance. All of these things reduce your risk of death. Now guys, if you've already walked 10 minutes this week, congratulations, you've already hit the minimum to get this reduced risk of death. Hit that like button. Congratulate yourself. The next activity on the list, gardening. Now, this one is less obvious, but it's just as effective and potentially more engaging than walking. In fact, many of the health benefits related to gardening are linked to its psychological effects, in addition to its function as an aerobic exercise. Increased mood, a clear way to engage in your exercise and prevent boredom, and even combating loneliness are all listed as reasons why gardening is a desirable form of leisurely exercise by the CDC. On top of that, it's simply a case of repeating weight-bearing motions. And then, at the end of it, you got a bunch of vegetables that you get to eat. Win-win. And dancing. Now, this one might sound like it could be pretty high intensity, but the study says that even light, casual dancing provides the same health benefits. Dancing is a form of endurance exercise that improves heart and lung function significantly. Also, once again, it has many psychological benefits. In one Italian study, people with a history of heart failure who took up waltzing improved their heart health, breathing, and quality of life significantly compared to those who biked or walked on a treadmill for exercise. These three activities could be the key to helping you survive longer. It should be noted that the study also gives evidence that the harder or longer you go, the greater the health benefits. I mean, it seems obvious, but it's true. 10 minutes to an hour a week of leisurely activity is the minimum to get this 18% reduced risk of death. But if you increase this to 150 minutes a week, the risk of all-cause mortality is reduced by 31%. That's huge. And remember, this is still leisurely activity. The study determined that 1 minute of vigorous exercise, like running on a treadmill, is equivalent to 2 minutes of these leisurely exercises, like gardening or walking. This is a stat that was also confirmed by the World Health Organization. So that's double, right? Like, in order to get that 31%, you would only need to do 75 minutes a week. The study was conducted by Chinese researchers who analyzed data of over 88,000 people aged 40 to 85. Their analysis accounted for the subjects' reported lifestyles, exercise routines, BMI, alcohol intake, everything. Their findings basically involved comparing those who had a more or less sedentary lifestyle with those that had low levels of leisure activity and those who had high levels of leisure activity. The analysis was published in the British Medical Journal and seems pretty conclusive that any exercise has significant health benefits compared to no exercise. So get out there for a 10-minute walk today, a 10-minute weed picking session tomorrow, or a 10-minute samba the next day. See for yourself how much it helps. If you guys like what we're doing here, like and subscribe. Check out inverse.com. We're gonna be doing a lot more just like this. I'm Justin. I'll see you guys next time.